Hello and welcome to the Vector Garden YouTube channel. I'm Monika and in this video I'm going to show you how to create these metaballs in Affinity Designer and in Adobe Illustrator. This is based on a new feature in Affinity Designer, and Serif has shown this example in their demo videos. And it's a nice example to show you some similarities between the two applications. Now, the nice thing about this, it's editable. So I can just double click it, go into it, and when I move one of these circles around, we're seeing the effect of these metaballs, and they change, and you can add more circles or other shapes to it and transform it into this figure. Now let's see how to get this. I'm going to another file and I have prepared the shapes in this. So these are just circles. To get started, we need to create a shape out of these. We need to combine these circles. Now you do this with Boolean operations, and they can be found in layer geometry. There's another way to create them, which is layers create compound. The difference between these is that this one is editable, and if you use geometry, it creates the shape and you can't move the parts of it around later, which we need. Another way to create these is by using these buttons. And again, when you just click a button, then it's baked in. So if I just click add, you see when I use the not tool, the direct selection tool, you see there are no more shapes visible. So I'm going to revert and revert again and again. So I've got the shapes again and I'm going to select all of them, press the Alt key or Option and then click on this button. And again, this looks like it's baked together, but you see in the Layers panel we have the single shape in this compound shape. This is called a compound shape, and you can create it also with going to the menu, layers, and then create compound. Now it's shown, so you can only tear it apart. The next thing you have to do is, when this is selected, go to the contour tool and then just move this in, and there you have the metaballs. This in Affinity Designer is editable. So I can deselect it and select it again, go to the contour tool again, and then move this and change it like so. Or I can enter the radius and enter all the other features. And if I want to edit it, I can take the selection tool and double click it and move them around. I can also press the Alt key to make a copy of it, and then I get more shapes and they get added to it automatically. And when I click to the side and then click it again, then I have selected the compound shape, and I can also add a different fill, you know, add a gradient to this like this, and then I can get to the one I've created here. Now let's look at this in Adobe Illustrator. In Illustrator I've also got these circles. I've already prepared them, and let's first combine them into a shape. To do this in Illustrator, you use the Pathfinder. In Window, Pathfinder. And again, you've got two different methods to combine them. I select them, and in order to combine them into one shape, you use Unite, and I can just click this. And let's see, in outline mode, this is all one shape. This is not what we want. So I'm going to revert this, and again, I can click the Alt or Option key and click on this. And you see there are still the circles, but we've got a compound shape named up there, and we've also got it in the Layers panel. You go to Window, Layers, and there you can see it. We've got the compound shape here, and inside we've got the circles. So let's go back to the preview, and this is now completely editable. Now, to get the metaballs, I have to use Offset Path. Offset Path can be found in two places. We go to Object, Path, and then Offset Path. But this makes it non-editable. So this will create a copy and then apply the offset. This is not what I want, because then I can't move things around or add to it. So we can find the offset path again in Effect, and Effect is a live effect. So I go to Effect, Path, and there is offset path. And the nice thing about it is it's not only a live effect, but also it doesn't create that copy, but it gets applied to the shape that I have. And in order to get the rounded things, like in Affinity Designer, we have to apply a negative value. So we have to move the offset to the inside. Now, like this, and we've got a corner applied here, and I can go to the rounded connection. So it's like this. I'm going to click OK. And then I can move them around. Like in Affinity Designer, I can use the double click. I'm in an isolation mode, and there I can move the single shapes around. And like in Affinity Designer, I can also click the Alt key to create some copies and edit them. I can also resize them and move them around, and you see the nice live drawing in here, which is an Illustrator function that has been added only in recent version. So if you have an older version, you won't see the live painting of this, but still you can also move it around. In order to get out of this, double click to the outside. Now we also want to edit the effect itself, you know, make the offset smaller or larger. Then you go to Window, Appearance, and there is the live effect. I can click in here, and then I can change the value of this. So you see, you can fully edit this thing in both applications. They're in different places, but fully editable.
If you liked the video, please give me a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel. See you next time.